Hey, what's going on, everybody? Welcome back to my channel. My name is Jacob Restituto. I'm a musician, producer, and songwriter from Northport, New York. Today, out of a ton of requests, I've been getting a lot of requests to do Kygo, so I apologize that I'm doing my best, as the best that I can. This is The Making of Higher Love, killer song, him and Whitney Houston. This is number one. I don't know if there's another one. I think this is the only one that I've seen. I love the behind-the-scenes things, and it's funny that I just am starting to react to them because I've been watching them for years. Everything that people put out, John Belly and Kygo, you know, all the different stuff that the genius, I love the genius stuff, and New York Times actually does a really good one. They did one with Justin Bieber, Skrillex, and Diplo, and Ed Sheeran on The Shape of You. Killer, they actually do a really, really good job. I like those, and I really enjoy the breakdown of it, so, but the funny thing is, I'm like, why haven't I been reacting to these? Like, this totally should be something, like, I break down and give my insight on. If you do enjoy this, let me know in the comments below, so I can know to do more of this stuff, and text me if you have any requests or anything like that, or questions. If you want to learn more about the production, I'm starting a production course on my Patreon, so you can check that out, and let's see what we got. Also, if you want to check out my music, it's Jacob Restituto, wherever you listen. Shout out to everybody that requested The Making of Kygo. Let's see what we got. This is Higher Love. Dude, even right there in that like little intro, first of all, the color grading on this is sick. Look at the pink in the through the window and the like very light blue sky. The funny thing about this is like he is made millions and millions and millions of dollars, and his studio is so simple. It's amazing, and I'm pretty sure that keyboard is like an M Audio keyboard. If I'm correct, it's like $50, which is amazing. Like that, he's making, you know, everybody thinks, oh, I need this stupid, expensive $10,000 keyboard. You know, he's using literally, there's no extra features on that. It's literally like keyboard with a modulation wheel and a pitch bend wheel, and that's it. And the shifting the octaves with the button. So funny, so funny.
Hey guys, so I've seen a lot of you ask me to do more videos from my studio when I make music. So I thought I could show you guys how I made the drop for Higher Love. So obviously I got sent this vocal. Bring me
a higher love. Dude, you hear the harmonies in that? First of all, imagine being at a place in your life where Whitney Houston's team sends you her vocal. Like, that's the dream, right?
Houston, which sounds amazing. So the first thing I did was just to find the chords.
Look at the view he has in that window, that's crazy. See, it makes me happy when I see other producers, like huge producers like him, use Logic, because the industry standard is Pro Tools, and the only reason I don't use Pro Tools is because I never learned on it. I learned how to make music on Logic, and I had been making music for years. I'm like, I'm not going to transition and learn a whole new thing. It's just not worth it to me at this point. Maybe one day I will, but like to see like the Chainsmokers, I believe, use Logic. And they go back and forth, I feel like. But Kygo, right here, you're seeing he's using Logic. So you know, that makes me feel like, hey, you know what? I'm going to use what I like, and it doesn't matter.
Some drums to the second part here.
I think that chord progression is going 4-1-5-6 if I'm correct. I love that you can hear the clickingness of the keyboards. I'm surprised they didn't just cut, like do like a direct out or something like this. You can actually hear his audio versus the actual like, clean audio, which is very funny. You know, he's a millionaire producer, and it's just funny how they recorded it. But people obviously don't care. It has 1.8 million views, so obviously people wanted to see this. He's a killer piano player.
Underneath.
See, I like that he's actually playing it and then showing you. It's not just him playing, pressing play, because it shows his musicality in it.
And then what I did was just to chop up the vocal from Whitney. So I have it. You can probably find tutorials online how to do that.
He's like, I'm not going through the whole thing. Let me show you what I have.
Make it a sample instrument where I have. You're knocking some things look so bad. Ever in this whole world, but that we. So I can just jam.
Do you hear the reverb on that? That's some serious reverb.
With the different vocal chops. So I was jamming just
It's nothing like getting a good vocal chop down.
Chords for a while.
So see, he's showing you the process where it's like, okay, let's see what sounds good together. This interval with this interval, this chop with this chop, this word with this word.
And then after a while, I came up with
I like that he still remembers how to play it. That's impressive, man. Come on, that's killer.
Found that was the catchiest kind of vocal chops I could come up with. The drums is coming in there as well.
Nice shaker. Really cinematic style, bro. Oh, you hear that shifted down vocal on the higher love? That was
cool. And then on the drop, I have this piano, which is probably the most prominent in the track that plays like this.
Here, look at all the different layers. I wish they kind of showed the screen a little more so you could see what he was using, the plugins and stuff. Because I like that. I'm like, oh, I want to know what synths and plugins and all that stuff. You see all the layers.
It's the same chords.
So you see him shifting down the octaves on that thing. It's not even an 88-key keyboard. Here, all these musicians like, I need this, you know, super good keyboard. He's using a cheap little keyboard.
And then I add, this is like 5 different synths and pianos. One.
Nice, that's cool to see all the different layers. Yo, it literally looks like some guy came in and shot it like this. I don't think it's even on a gimbal, because you can see it moving around. It's so funny. So funny. I like that sound.
Top of each other, which sounds like this.
You hear the side chain? You see that, so that pulsing that's in it's something called side chain. That's creating that movement and that pulsing. And that pulsing gives extra movement. It makes you want to move your head. You like move it to the song.
A lot of, you know, hi-hats, kick drum, snare, everything.
Ooh, very 80s sound. Tight kicking.
Hi-hats.
Boots and cats and boots and cats and boots and cats and. Nice. Multi-rhythm, polyrhythm. I really appreciate the fact that he can play everything back after he's made the song. Because sometimes I'm like, I create something in my songs, and I'm like, how in the world did I play that? You know what I mean?
Something like this. The sub under it.
Oh, you hear that sub? Nice.
Chords.
Pulsing in, low pass filter opening it up.
Kicks.
Wow, really top end kick. You hear that? Really bright kick. Really bright kick. Benefit of that is it comes through small speakers like an iPhone. Look at this rhythm section. This is killer.
So when you add it all together, it sounds like this.
I wonder if he mixes everything himself, or if he sends that to like a mixer, an engineer, and mixes. They mix. Knock it down.
Done.
That it makes it look so easy. That's crazy, man. Very cool. Well, I hope you guys enjoyed that. As always, you can leave a comment, you can text. Like I said, this was a request. I had a bunch of requests to do more Kygo, so I'm trying to do more of it. Try to make you guys happy. If you are happy, hit that subscribe button, and I will see you in the next video. Do me a huge favor, check out my music, and I'll see you later. Peace out. Yeah. just